Hey, welcome back to the Ping Pong Fleek Show. My name is Chris Wong. There's a few updates for you today. Lots of DC content to cover, so let's get right into it. But before we actually get on to that, I forgot. I have to talk about the new shirts that my wife made for me. It's really awesome. Some of you were asking for the genre, etc. That would be insane! And there it is. That would be insane! A t-shirt right there. Only in the front, like nice simple design for that. Also, she created a Superman-ish symbol, a PPF, a little bit of that Flash Thunder there with the Justice League star on it as well. So that's another T as well. So it comes in, I think that's blue and white. Also, my other shirts, Let Them Fight, which is still popular. Ping Pong Flicks, the Flash shirt, Flash mug, Let Them Fight, Justice League Ping Pong Flicks only on YouTube. More of that, that would be insane. And there's actually a cool, also, you know, Victor Koo's design here for me, my Pegasus. And this cool little mug here, God versus King Ping Pong Flicks. I hope you like that. So please check out, and also Zactivated, of course, is still there. Check it out over on my Ping Pong Flicks merchandise store. Also down below, you know, there's only select shirts that I could pull up underneath me. But if you go to the actual Teespring store in the description, then yeah, there's more selection there. All right, well, let's get into the topics of the day. The first topic is Avatar. Avatar apparently updated their website, and they have actual dates for all the other sequels on here right now. So Avatar 2 says December 16th, 2022. Avatar 3, December 20th, 2024. Avatar 4, December 18th, of 2026. Avatar 5, December 22nd, of 2028. Boy, I wish we could see Zack Snyder's Justice League 2, Justice 3. But it's amazing that he's able to do this, and that's awesome. Hopefully now it's a set date. We're actually going to get to see it, because we've been hearing about Avatar 2 to 5 forever. And are we ever going to see it? Is it long overdue? Is anybody interested at this point? I don't know. But there are Avatar fans out there, apparently. I'm curious about it. I'm not a real big fan, but I am curious to see what other innovative things he would be able to pull from the new Avatar movies, right? So let's see what happens with that. Right, moving along to Marvel. Well, maybe. Emily, this is coming from Culture Crave, Howard Stern Show. Emily Blunt says that her and John Krasinski haven't been contacted about starring in Fantastic Four. She's also not a fan of superhero films. It's not that it's beneath me, but I don't like them. I really don't. So she doesn't like it. But, you know, John Krasinski maybe he could be, you know, in there, because he would pretty be a really good Reed Richards for Fantastic Four. It will get another Sue Storm or something, but Fantastic Four, that symbol there for the Marvel Studios, definitely doing a Fantastic Four, but I guess it's not going to be Emily Blunt. Or maybe even John Krasinski. I guess they have somebody else in mind for that movie. Speaking of Marvel, Dave Bautista thinks Marvel Studios dropped the ball on Drax's great backstory. And I'll read you the whole quote right here from Collider that they put on their article. That role changed the trajectory of my life. It's always going to be special to me. Now that I'm four films in, I really wish they would have invested more in Drax, personally, because I think Drax has more of a story to tell. I think Drax has a really interesting backstory, which they dropped the ball on. That's no dig on Marvel. They had their slate. I know what they're focused on. That's what they've slated out. But man, I think they really missed the ball on Drax. He has such a great backstory, selfishly as a performer, that would have given me the opportunity to show different sides of Drax emotionally and physically as well. Because if you notice, Drax, although he looks like a badass, you look at him and he looks terrifying. But Drax gets his ass kicked more than any other Marvel character. The whole destroyer thing, they just threw that out the window. People just fell so in love with the comedic side of Drax. They tapped into that. Then they tapped into it more. Then they really dug a hole into it. But we missed a huge bone on that character. And I don't think it'll ever come back around. But I'm just really looking forward to finishing out this whole journey. I mean, it really sounds like I'm moving on. I'm a lead character in Army of the Dead. I'm in Knives Out. And, like, I'm moving. I'm getting bigger and bigger roles. More meaningful roles. Yeah, he's kind of like, I'm done. You know, after this last one, I'm done being that comedic douchebag douchery in the Marvel Universe. And rightfully so. I agree. He was best in the first one. And then they just made a joke out of him afterwards. It just was ridiculous. Like, what? Like, at least let him maybe one of the last blow to Thanos or something, you know, to get his, because he was trying to, he was revenge for his family. But that's unfortunate, and I think deep down, even though he says it's not a dig on Marvel, deep down it is a dig on Marvel, and deep down he's like, you know what, I'm glad this is all coming to an end. I'm glad that I'm not going to be Drax anymore. I'm glad I can move on to more meaningful roles, roles that are more important to me, and show my ability to act rather than be a joke or just be a brute. So I think this is really good. This is really cool. That he's moving forward onward more. And we'll talk a little bit more about Army of the Dead later on. All right, let's move on to, I think we're going into DC now. Yep, speaking of James Gunn and the Guardians of the Galaxy, James Gunn said that the Suicide Squad is going to be in theaters in the UK on July 30th. Now, I think I misspoke yesterday about how Black Adam was finishing up and it was like August. And like, I don't know, my life is totally bonkers right now. So my days and months, it's like mishmashing. August is farther away. It's like 3 months away, or even almost 3.5 months away. So, okay, I understand that. That's totally like, yeah, it's not next month. Hello. So it's a little bit farther than that. So anyway, see, so Suicide Squad's gonna be in theaters in the UK on July 30th. So they get to see it at least a little bit earlier, a little bit earlier than we get, you know, than we'll get to see it, right? Speaking, now we're going to The Flash now. It seems that Maribel Verdú, I think that's how you say her name, who plays Nora Allen, has already started filming her scenes in The Flash. First week of filming, she said, at Instagram. And I guess that's what she's going to look like. That's her as Nora Allen. So now we see the first official look at Nora Allen. Like, we don't even have an official look for Flash like, or Michael Keaton, but we get to see Nora Allen as, you know, well, Maribel Verdú as Nora Allen, and that's how she would look like in the Flash movie. Black Adam, this one is really interesting. So Black Adam updates, or Black Adam news, says Black Adam's currently searching for a top secret body double, right? And he had to, you know, he when somebody asked, it doesn't say top secret. He says he cut that part off. It's actually on the actual casting on the top secret. Job description, DC's Black Adam casting call, body double casting notice. Major feature film is currently casting for a body double in excellent shape. Casting for Caucasian male, 25 to 45 years old, 6'1", 180, 195, and in excellent superhero shape. This will work in the next few weeks. What could it be? What are we talking about here? Why is it top secret? And why is it a body double? I mean, there's many times there's like stunt doubles and stuff like that. But no, this is a body double for Black Adam movie. What could this be? Well, DC Versal is kind of guessing that is someone who lends his body on the screen because the actor can't do the scene. Remember, there was one actor who couldn't do the scene in the cafeteria scene? Henry Cavill, right? So are we again assuming that Henry Cavill once again does not want to be just a cameo in this movie. Just another cameo in this movie. He's probably looking for the bigger contracts at this point, right? So he's like, I don't want to waste my one opportunity on a cameo. So let's get a secret tops, you know, let's get a body double to be that, you know, the same look. I don't know why they couldn't just get the last guy, maybe, but I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what this actually means. DCversal thinks it may be Superman, and I hope not, because that means that, you know, not everything's working out and they're still negotiating, and Henry Cavill doesn't just want to waste this one away, or maybe he's not even involved anymore and he's not Superman anymore. I don't know, you know, don't get too far about that, but just it's interesting because that is around, you know, he's not, I don't think he's, yeah, you know, he's around that. That fits his description. That fits Henry Cavill's description pretty much, you know, not to the T, I don't think, but it's pretty much like that. So, man, that would be a waste. That would be unfortunate that he wasn't able to make it as Superman, or they're still working through contracts, and while filming, they're not going to be able to get through all that until, you know, even after filming is done. Like, she could still do reshoots, maybe. Maybe they're doing this for now as a fill-in, and then reshoots later. And then when Henry Cavill's available or whatever, then he can come in and do that. I don't know yet. This is interesting. It's a very interesting, and it makes me wonder. Now, the even more interesting about this is that some of the scoopers who know what's happening retweet this with a, I'm keeping my mouth shut. Meaning they know something about this. They know that this is very much top secret and it's important. It's not something like it's not a big deal. Because if it's not a big deal, they'll come out and say, it's not a big deal. Come on. Because, you know, they want to be the know-it-all, right? The scoopers are all like, I know everything you don't. So we're going to put up. But for them to say zip, that means something. So I'm willing to bet. I don't know how much. I'm willing to bet this actually might be, maybe in the meantime, having a Superman cameo in there. Oh, Black Adam versus Superman, you think so? Would Superman be the one to take down Black Adam as a maybe a cliffhanger to the next Black Adam movie? Because I'm feeling like if they really want to make this big, make this excellent, make this something like, oh crap, I gotta see the next one. Oh crap, this is really cool. Black Adam versus Superman, cliffhanger. Let's get to the real battle of the next one. Perfect, because after Black Adam is gonna be the Shazam Fury of the Gods, and then gives him a little time to build up, right? Build up to the big fight that The Rock, Dwayne The Rock Johnson has wanted ever since he sat together with Henry Cavill at that table drinking whatever. Black Adam versus Superman. Maybe. I don't know. But we'll see. All right. So let's talk about Army of the Dead for a little bit. Army of the Dead now is on Rotten Tomatoes now with a whopping 79% fresh tomato. Yeah, I don't care about Rotten Tomatoes. You don't care about Rotten Tomatoes. But some people do. And so if you wanted to know, 79% said this, right? 79% is fresh. Now, it's amazing to see that if Zack Snyder got to do what he got to do, right? What he was able to do, unhinged Zack Snyder apparently has a better fresh Rotten Tomatoes to his score than before. So it makes you wonder, well, if Warner Bros. Just let him do whatever the F he wanted, would have they got positive critic review? All this hate towards Zack Snyder is unwarranted, and actually Warner Brothers hurt his name by not letting him do what he wants. But now he's getting to prove that this is me, this is my type of movie. It has actually gone up. It was like at 71 and went to 78, I think, and now it's 79. An ambitious, over-the-top zombie heist movie, Army of the Dead brings Zack Snyder back to his genre roots with a suitably gory splash. So it's very good here. I didn't get to review it yet because I didn't get to watch it yet. But you know, guess what? I get to watch it this Friday. I can't wait. And then right after, I'm going to let you know my first reaction, probably coming out of the theater, first reaction. And then, you know, a proper review right after. So be on the lookout for that. All right. Well, we're talking about Zack Snyder. And apparently Zack Snyder actually responds to the Superman they're calling it a reboot because they don't understand anything about multiverse right now. But it's a totally separate thing. It's outside of the DCEU. Response to Superman with a black lead actor. This is long overdue. So I'm going to read to you what he actually said here. I'm going to read the article. So Zack Snyder, Blockbuster filmmaker J.J. Abrams is attached to produce the upcoming feature, and he'll be collaborating with journalist and writer Ta-Nehisi Coates, who will pen the script, having previously specialized in reporting and exploring issues facing the African-American community. Currently, no director or actors are attached to the project, but Warner Brothers will be casting a black actor in the role of Superman, which would be a first in live action, though the precedent has already been set in the comic books. This is what Zack Snyder had to say about that. My feeling is that I love J.J. Abrams. I love what he's done in the past. I'm interested to see what happens. It's a bold and cool and probably long overdue move. But I love Henry Cavill as Superman. Of course I do. He's my Superman. I'm not really involved in any of the decision making at Warner Brothers in any way. So I guess for me, it's just wait and see what they do with this and how it manifests itself. But on the surface, it seems interesting. So at least he honestly say that that's interesting. That would be it's long overdue. But also at the same breath, he's kind of saying, but you know, I don't know about that. That's what they're doing. My Superman, essentially my universe Superman, is Henry Cavill. I love Henry Cavill. I don't want to be like he's replacing him or anything like that. That's my universe. But I'm okay, and it's interesting to see what happens on that side. And he's expressed that, you know, many times about interested to see how his own characters develop, right? He's looking forward to how the actors and actresses he cast in those roles. Gal Gadot is Wonder Woman, Jason Momoa is Aquaman, Ezra Miller is Flash. He is actually absolutely looking forward to them growing over on the other side. You know, he's like, hey, you know, the Snyderverse is my thing over here, but I'm really happy to see the folks that, you know, I created, and they are moving on. They're building their own careers and their own future as those characters that I created in a way on that Warner Brothers side. So that's him, you know, Zack Snyder feeling that type of way. And it's absolutely, like, if we're fighting for, he always wanted creative freedom for himself, and he's always said, look, I want creative freedom for myself. It wouldn't be fair to say that other directors couldn't have their creative freedom as well. And I agree. If we're fighting for creative integrity for Zach, we have to fight for directors and creative integrity for all directors, right? I mean, that's the whole point of artistic integrity, my bad. And so other directors get to do what they want, and I'm happy for that. And I'm hoping that Zack Snyder will get to do what he wants, hopefully later on for the Snyderverse, but also all the next projects that he has in store for him. I'm still looking forward to that original sci-fi film. Come on, I'm wondering if that's the next thing, right? Since Horse Latitudes is delayed, is the original sci-fi film the next thing? I don't know. I guess we'll have to wait and see. All right, let's get into members' comments and questions now. Kal-El of Krypton, what I always thought regarding a possible Man of Steel story, 2 story, and wanted to ask Zach on Vero, when the world engine is destroyed in Man of Steel, you briefly see 3 greenish-blue lights in a triangle formation. Is that a Brainiac Easter egg? I don't know. That's an interesting one. I'm not on Twitter, and when I read the anti-Semitic comments regarding Gal Gadot, I'm reminded why I'm not on that internet, skid mark. You know, I haven't been on Twitter that lately. I saw something today, and I said my piece, and I just left it because I'm like, I'm so busy right now. I'm not even on Twitter. Like, I go to Twitter at the end of the day, like right now, to gather all the information I could find and stuff. And there were certain DMs I was able to respond to, but that was about it. So, but yeah, hopefully I'll have a little bit more time, but hopefully I grabbed enough of the content that was important, was interesting for you, every single day. At this point, I'm wondering if Leslie Jones is going to be Zach's granny goodness. Hey, that's not bad. They told me not to include a lot of stuff that I did. What was there other stuff Zach shot, but but cut because Warner Bros. Wanted him to, or did he just manage to keep everything else but Green Lantern? He said he wanted to, he was able to do all the lot of stuff, because remember he said that Darkseid, they want no Darkseid whatsoever, but he was able to put that in. Green Lantern was the last thing that he could not put in. Gee, Zach going into a Man of Steel 2, which would have had set up Batman who views Supes with suspicion, really gets me frustrated with Warner Brothers and their desire to jump into a Batman vs. Superman film. Had they let Zach stay with his original vision to first get Superman's house in order, as he put it in a Man of Steel publicity tour, the DCU would have been on a much more stable ground and audiences would have been more on board. But absolutely, take the Batman setup out, and it'd be awesome to have this film after Zach's Justice League arcs. Still with Henry Cavill's and Amy's Lois, with their son, of course, maybe have said it Tom after the end of the arc, Bruce Kent no longer a baby. And I think that's the point. It would have been after the whole Justice League arc. Chris for president! Nah, that's already stressful. I'll be president of Ping Pong Flicks. How's that? The Brainiac idea was pre-BVS, and if you go by what Zack said in early interviews, he didn't really want to do that because it would be another alien invasion movie. But the idea of the last scene being Bruce Wayne getting a crate of kryptonite, then they started to explore that thread, and we ended up with BVS. Cree, I low-key was getting nervous that you were not going to drop your trademark. It's going to be insane. I breathed a sigh of relief when you finally dropped it at the end. You know what's funny? Because the shirts now, it says, that would be insane. And I asked my wife, do I say that would be insane or it's going to be insane? And she's like, you say both. Sometimes you say that be insane. But she already had, you know, it says that would be insane. So I'm like, oh, I'll just keep it, you know. At least the insane is in there. Would love to see Brainiac and Puriex too. I would love to see that. Would they don't reboot? As long as they don't reboot, Terry, we can keep moving forward. And the more we move forward, the more villains we can introduce in, right? Imagine rebooting again and Zod again, Luther. Oh, come on. Just keep moving forward. One Shot Pro says, I always thought that being inside the empty pod in the Kryptonian scout ship was Brainiac. It makes sense even though 20,000 years has passed by the time MLS happens. Maybe Brainiac was the cause of Krypton's destruction. Brainiac left the planet to aid the Kryptonian scientists in their quest. Brainiac probably sabotaged the mission and the ship crash landed on Earth. That would have been a really cool open credit sequence for Man of Steel 2, Restore Snipers. Whoa, that's interesting. I never heard that one, but that's a good one. What if that was Brainiac? Huh. I kind of like that. Huh. What if anybody else thought of that? You know, maybe ask Zach that. He's not going to tell us because, you know, there may be a chance that we'll get to see something like that in the future. Hopefully. Crossing all fingers and toes. All right, well, that is it. Like I said, if you want me to read your comment or question, please join as a member down below. Please get a shirt down below and support the channel as much as can. Thank you very much. I truly appreciate it. But like I said, if you absolutely love this daily dose of entertainment news, then, you know, every day, it's pretty much daily at this point, please click the like button, hit the subscribe button, ring that notification bell, keep this hot dog light on, and I'll see you next time. Bye.